Man Group CEO is not someone that is good at evaluating fundamental values to start with.
Well, what
this
if,
guy
what
trades
this,
price.
This guy's Luke Ellis. He's the head of Man Group. What if he was to phone you up tomorrow and say, hey, man, I want to do business with you?
I'll do business with you.
You'd be like, Steven, erase that video.
Erase.
Okay, everybody, welcome to another episode of Crypto with Amin.
Oh, my favorite color.
Crazy crypto expert, crypto dummy. If you like these videos, like, comment, subscribe.
I read.
Okay, today's video is going to be a reaction video. Reaction to a recent article in the Financial Times, no less. The article is by Gary Silverman.
Yeah.
It was published on the 26th of July.
Mm-hmm.
And the headline is, Man Group Boss. Crypto has no inherent worth, but is good to trade. Luke Ellis compares digital assets to the 17th century Dutch tulip craze.
Mm.
The chief executive of Man Group, the world's largest listed hedge fund manager, says cryptocurrencies have no inherent worth, but are creating trading opportunities for his company because of their wild price swings.
Let's first of all talk about the worth of Man Group themselves. What
who,
do they
who,
do?
Who are
these
Man
guys?
Group? Who are they?
So what they do? The largest listed hedge fund manager. You know what listed hedge fund manager means?
No.
Okay, so listed hedge fund managers are basically hedge funds, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So people that have very risky strategy or have freedom into deploy certain risks, and they found their way into attracting big capital by going to IPOs, okay? So what's their added value into the economy? Nothing. So sorry to discredit you to about this, but Man Group CEO is not someone that is good at evaluating fundamental values.
He says if you look at cryptocurrencies as a whole, it is a pure trading instrument.
So look, this is an argument that you probably could see back in 2017. Crypto is obviously a competitor to him because crypto gives access directly to same level of yields, same level of risk profiles, etc., to retail investors, okay, which reduces his capability of raising capital. So obviously crypto is not good for his business model.
I will say that the London-based Man Group manages 127 billion for clients.
So that's basically 7% of the total market cap of crypto.
We like to be long and short depending on what the models say is likely to happen to the market.
Yeah.
And we will trade it long and short just as happily as in as big a size as a market liquidity lets you trade, he says.
This statement is basically, it's called the Wall Street bullshit, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because
sounds like it to me.
Yes, because
not being an expert.
Yeah, exactly.
He said cryptocurrencies were things to trade because they go up and down a bunch.
Yeah,
that's pretty base, isn't it, there, from a guy who's probably on, how much is he on?
Yeah.
The number one thing, he says, that clients are worried about is inflation.
That's right. His question is, how do you hedge for inflation? And what people are looking for is being able to take a contrarian position.
Like,
no, contrarian.
Oh.
Contrarian. That means if there is inflation goes up, they have an asset that also goes up. So it counters the destructive nature of inflation. But he doesn't have to make, he's not in a position to make macroeconomical calls.
Why not? This guy's been around.
He's been around and but his hedge fund is completely insensitive to this stuff. Why? Because their game is to list a hedge fund, raise money from retail, from institutions, whatever, because they list their hedge fund in the stock market. And they take that money and they invest it in whatever yield-generating environment.
So
what they're looking for, like the whole market, is deflationary assets. Deflationary assets, why? Because they are by nature a hedge against inflation. Now, is crypto a hedge against inflation? I don't know, we'll see. But inflation is coming and we'll see if crypto is going to become a hedge.
Final quote from him, he says, I think we stay in a world of very low rates until central banks lose control. And when they lose control, it's not going to be fun, he said.
That's right.
For some of the strategies we trade, we might do very well, but that doesn't mean it's a good thing.
This is called the politically correct Wall Street BS. So what he's saying is that he trades prices, okay? But he trades prices but and he doesn't care about the underlying assets. But if the market turns around, or there's inflation goes up, spikes up, well, it's not going to be great for all his funds. If you trade prices, you don't care, right? You don't care about the fundamental value of a bond. You don't care about the fundamental value of a company. You don't care about the fundamental value of a cryptocurrency.
The cool thing is that in this article, they've got a nice photograph of tulips. I mean, tulips, because he's compared it to...
the tulip bubble.
Yeah, who's actually going to know anything about that?
Well, people know, but...
Well, not many, though.
Yeah.
You need to, like, look up Wikipedia or something once you read that and go look up the tulip bubble of the late 17th century Dutch financial mania crisis.
Yeah, but what he fails to underline there is that this tulip bubble was the start of a very lasting industry.
Do you know about the tulip bubble?
Yes. Oh. Was the start of a very lasting industry in the Netherlands, which positioned the Netherlands, although after this big fail from a speculative perspective, on centuries-long dominance in the flower industry as a trading hub. That was the spark in the continuation of one of the most lasting trading industries and stable trading industries for the Netherlands that lasts until today. Yeah, I'm a little bit allergic to all these Wall Street bosses because, first of all, most of these guys, you know, they entered to the game of finance as a junior. He never had to put up his own money. He runs a big operation, and kudos to him. But fundamentally,
he's trying to protect his own little space. Is that what you're trying
exactly.
to say?
Exactly. Fundamentally. Yeah.
He's trying to look after his corner.
Of course.
Yeah. Okay. Do you agree with Amin? Do you agree with Luke Ellis? What do you think? Leave comments below. Like, comment, subscribe. Say goodbye, Amin.
Goodbye.